Many of the New Orleans residents vividly remember the day 7 years ago when Hurricane Katrina hit and the levees failed, flooding the city. It changed many people's lives, including an Oahu woman and her family who used to live in New Orleans. Marissa Yamane has more.
Joe, the Ferchauds had planned to retire in Hawaii, but because of Katrina, their move to the islands happened much sooner than expected.
New Orleans native Jody Ferchaud was in Honolulu for her son's graduation from U-H when Hurricane Katrina hit.
And we were ticketed to fly home the day the storm hit. And then the levees broke.
She says her husband went back to New Orleans about a month later, called her and said, "Find a house for us, we're not coming back."
My home was closer to the lake, so it wasn't as damaged. It didn't have the level of water that homes had that were approximately a block away from me. So it started at about a block from the lake, 6 to 8 inches is what I had in my home. I didn't really move anything from New Orleans, a few things I brought with me, but I started over here in Honolulu and we love it.
The Ferchauds bought a house in Wailaiki and haven't looked back, but now they're looking ahead, hoping their friends who still live in New Orleans will be okay.
Everyone I talked to today said that they were not leaving. Most of them were just in awe of the fact that it's scheduled to hit the day that Katrina hit.
Isaac is expected to be weaker than Katrina, and most of Katrina's deaths and destruction happened when the levees failed. But now, 7 years later, the levees are improved, and the city's pump stations have backup generators ready in case the power goes out.
I'll be honest with you, if New Orleans gets hit again, I think this is over for a lot of people. Many people didn't go back to New Orleans, but this will be more than anybody could handle. If you have to deal with this every 5 years, it's just, it's bankrupting emotionally, psychologically, physically.
And New Orleans is still in the midst of recovering from Katrina. While some neighborhoods have been rebuilt, others are still filled with empty, dilapidated homes. Marissa Yamane, KH12 News, Hawaii's news leader.